Well, we're up here at Aquayot Harbor at the Pickwick Lake, beautiful Pickwick Lake, and we're just about to start the, I guess you'd call it charity event to benefit the foundation, getting ready for the river run again, and this money we raise tonight will benefit and go to build the new cancer treatment center. And what we're doing is the songwriters in the round. I've got Jim Brown, one of my producers, we call him Moose. I got Steve Love, one of my friends, co-writers. Walt Aldridge is here to play, and myself, and we're going to get up and do three or four rounds here, and folks came out and bought a plate. My buddies cooked catfish, so it's just a big hoopla. I mean, you know, we're going to throw down, and when this is over, we'll throw down some more. That's the way we do it around here at Pickwick. Y'all come.
I just happened to be standing around here when all of y'all started showing up for the show tonight, and I say stuff like this every year, but I just hope that after you've heard it year after year, because there's so many faces out there tonight that I've seen at this event so many times before. And to me, that means a whole lot. You don't, you know, you could do it one year and say, well, we did our good deed and not ever come back again, and we still wouldn't think any less of you. But so many of you show up year after year. I think it means two things. It means maybe you enjoy this, and number two, you're good people for supporting the cause, and we really, really, really do appreciate it. Thanks for coming. Well, let you start this day off, Moose.
Boy, put all the pressure on me, why don't you?
Moose has had a hit or two. I'm sure he's going to tell you about it.
Well, I'm kind of shy. I don't like to talk about it all that much, but yeah, I have. Thank you, ladies. You know, as songwriters, we typically try to write things that we have lived in our lives and write the truth all the time. So this is a true story if I've ever told it. Well, he stopped loving her today. I wrote that in 68.
Wow.
Song of the year at the CMAs. That'd be me. I wrote it down on a Shoney's napkin, turned paper into platinum. That'd be me. Well, them boys down on Music Row said they could put it on the radio if I would sign my name on a release. So I didn't get paid and I didn't get the credit. But if you wonder who really said it, that'd be me. True story. Well, now Big and Rich are a real hot act, mixing country and rock and roll and rap. Do you ever wonder who came up with all that? Well, that'd be me.
Till I catch my second wind, get back up and gain control again. Find the strength I lost back when you stopped loving me. Catch my second wind.
Every time I sing that line, I think about the first time I ever played this out. After Travis Tritt made it a hit, I was all swollen up and proud. And I went out and played it for a crowd. This guy came up to me right after I finished. He said, man, I love that Bonnie and Clyde song, but I'm a truck driver and there ain't no truck stop in Johnson City, Tennessee. I was cold busted. I said, that's what we call artistic license.
I was gassing up my fiber when I heard her calling me. She said, which way are you headed, boy? Do you need some company? Hey, it sounds like life to me. Ain't no destiny. Yeah, the only thing for certain is uncertainty, and you gotta hold on tight, just enjoy
something should happen. Stop it sometime to say hello to Catherine. You and Marianne could always keep her laughing. She's gonna need a lot of that. Take her out to a movie. It's gonna take some time before she's back on her feet. I know you think that I'll be fine and I'm talking crazy. There's always that chance. That's why I'm asking. If something should happen,
I say there's something's worth fighting for. What about our freedom and this piece of ground? We didn't get to keep it back in day.
I'm getting paid by the hour and older by the minute. My boss just pushed me over the limit. I'd love to call it something, but I think I'll just call it a day. Help me out.
Yeah. Oh, there's something tall and strong. We get a hurricane before I go insane. It's only 12:30, but I don't care. Cause it's 5 o'clock.
Hey, I hate to interrupt you, and I hate to complain, because I'm not a complainer. Yeah. This is the worst Diet Coke I've ever had in my life.
I bet, I don't know, it's making your head swim.
It's making me feel funny, and I don't hate to just come up here and complain, but I'm going to finish that silly light bulb there, and then I ain't having no more.
Somehow I can't seem to get it up.
I'm sorry, Steve. Go right ahead.
Time is right. Let's get together down where the heck is bad. Cooped up all winter, waiting on a day like this. It's the way I feel when I'm rocking on the water, baby, that I can't resist. Barbecue grill, summertime jam, just about a mile above a Pickwick dam. Party on the water, whole lot of fun. Time to make a Tennessee real good one.
Sick was all she said. It was one little prayer that made it through the cracks. Tipped the scales and the answers came back. Sounded just a little bit different from the others up there. Never underestimate one little prayer.
So everybody whistle Dixie.